What is up, gang? Welcome back to Kubrick and to yet another amazing video. This is going to be episode 2 of my newest project, in which we are going to a tropical island with everybody's favorite plastic wild man, the Islanders. That's right, I've been working on the Forbidden Island for the last 2 weeks, and I have some significant progress to show to you. The last 2 weeks were crazy and I had a lot of other work to do, but I managed to spend a few nights building up this awesome mock. And I gotta tell you, it's getting better with every brick. Of course, if you're wondering what is this dude talking about, then I encourage you to go and see the first episode of this building series. In short, I am rebuilding a mock I did 2 years ago when I first came back to LEGO after my dark ages. To be honest, when I look at the thing that I'm building, this is gonna be nothing like the old vignette. I can already see how much progress I've made in terms of techniques used and the overall knowledge of the building process. Like I said last time, I'm planning to keep the series about 3 episodes, and I think I'm going to keep that promise, but there is some significant progress done. So let's jump into it, shall we? As you can see, I've already completed the front beach part and moved to the jungle area. The sand on the beach is made in the same style as the wet part of it was, that is with some wedge plates and some tiles. I think that the shape of the beach turned out pretty nice and the overall look is quite realistic. I tried to form the sand as the real thing would be, pushed by the wind and waves. One thing that immediately catches the eye is the cage hanging over the water. I wanted to include some piece of detail on the beach, but I didn't know what, so I'm happy I came up with this one. The Islanders are a part of a classic pirate team after all, so they couldn't be absent from the smog, at least in some form. It's a pretty simple design for the cage, but it looks very effective. I may add some elements to it to make the frame look more natural, but for now it serves its purpose. I am planning to use the pirates also in a different way, but more of that in a minute. The sides of the freeform base here where the sand ends are finished with a little bit of snot technique, and it's not a bad transition between the wet sand and the foliage going deeper into the island. And speaking of, I already made most of the vegetation on both sides of the mock. As you could see in the previous episode, I started with standard grass stems that I placed below the sand level. Thanks to this technique, I've managed to make the transition from sand to plants a bit smoother. Looking deeper into the flora, I switched to using the standard leaves, both big and small ones. This way, I managed to put many layers of foliage, making it look more realistic, and also I could use the holes in the leaves to place some other plants. I've placed a lot of these seaweed bars and some carrot tops to make the grass more dense, and there are even some branches sticking out of the grass. And of course, you can see all the big leaf stems I got in my last bricks and pieces haul. And man, I really love how they fill the space and how much of a jungle vibe they give to the build. The same technique was used on both sides, but I didn't want them to look exactly the same, so I decided to put different bushes and trees on each side. So on the left here we have few small bushes with flowers and bit lighter colors, while on the right there is some less colorful elements but bigger bushes. And the trees are different as well, two on each side. On the right we have two palm trees. The bigger one is using the old school palm trunk but placed upside down and some bright green palm leaves. While the smaller one has a brick built trunk and the old leaves from the classic Islander sets. On the left side, on the other hand, we have a much brighter palm tree, also using the old trunk, but finished with a dark tan bush piece. The second tree on this side is using a lot of those flower stems put inside a standard big leaf piece. I gotta say that I'm very happy of how this tree turned out. I made it tilted to one side and bent near the top to make it even more tropical-like. I left some space behind the trees to have more flexibility while making the rock work, because that will be the next step toward completing the whole island. But before I talk about the rock, a quick mention about the middle part. Like I said last time, I wanted to make a sandy pathway leading to the cave that will be in the middle, but I don't want this part to be just sand. Therefore, I think I will put an altar that the Islanders will use to make a sacrifice. And what better offering to give to the island gods than a human one? So here is where the second pirouette will come in. I already have a basic idea of how I want the altar to look like and how it will be positioned on the mock. And then behind the altar will be the entrance to the cave, which will be made as a stone face of some sort. On the sides of the rock formations, I am trying a new way to make the rock work. The slopes are being placed on their sides, which should make a pretty nice rock texture. I've started already layering the rocks and it's looking alright for now, but I'm still hesitant about the sides though. I started placing the slopes vertically, but I think I will make them on the sides as well and make a smooth transition between the front and the sides. For now, at least it gives me an idea how tall would the cliff be. Of course, just on the sides because I wanted to get higher in the middle where the stone face will be. But as usual, it can always change during the build process, and that is what I like the most about building. And that's about it for what the actual progress is and how I'm planning to move forward. As for the next segment, which is going to be the finale, it may take a little longer than usual, probably to the first half of January, and that is because of three things. First of all, it's the holiday season, so I probably won't be building as much as I would like to, but I still want to make as much as possible because there is a lot of work ahead of me. And that's the second reason. Even though I have the beach and the jungle mostly done, I still have to make the whole rockwork in the back and the stone face with the cave entry in the middle. And I think that is going to take the most time of all. Of course, there is also an altar to build, which simply just cannot be too simple. And finally, the most important reason why the finale will have to be postponed is that I'm waiting for the 21st minifigure series to come out. The Jaguar Warrior that was announced from this series is a figure that I just have to have on this mock. Oh, and in the meantime, there will be at least one Bricklink order, because I need to order more blue diamonds for the water and hopefully a King Kahuka mask. So while you wait for the finish island, be sure to leave a like on this video if you're enjoying this series so far and let me know in the comments section what do you think about the build. You can also follow me on Instagram where I'll be posting some work in progress pics as I usually do in my stories. And you can click here if you somehow missed the first episode of this series, or check out this playlist to see some of the other mocks I've made. With that said, I wish you all best for the holiday season and for the whole 2021. Stay safe and keep it brickin'.